our cell phones, how we love them, cradle them, take them everywhere. Smash them? What would drive someone to do that?
Think of it as a weapon, because these are the trouble that you people can get into with using these devices is so big.
That's right. That cyber detective said weapon, because phones, new and old, are gold mines.
Look at what you store in your wallet. Your digital assets are much more valuable than the tangible currency that we use today.
With consumers upgrading phones more frequently, we wanted to know what happens with the old ones, especially if you're planning on trading it in, selling, or donating it. We gathered up a bunch from around KHON2's office. They were supposedly reset, but you may be surprised what's hiding among them. So I have six phones here that are wiped clean. What do you see?
Money. A lot of money here. Maybe tens of thousands of dollars, because on those phones, basically anything you put on the on your phone is like a computer. It can be extracted even though you think that it's been erased.
So how is that possible? Phone medic Kenny Amazaki.
You can do a soft reset on your phone, which only resets the operating system.
That doesn't clean the slate, but supposedly the factory reset will. When I hit factory reset before I hand over a phone, is it wiped clean?
In some cases, people with special equipment or special software can go into the phone and retrieve bits and pieces of data, birth date information, address information, social security number, banking numbers, and things like that, that they can potentially either sell or exploit themselves. Right?
And the risk is not only financial.
You've got a list of all their pictures. This is tied to the photo, the camera of the phones.
Your life mapped by locator data on the photos you take. We showed that to this phone's owner.
Do you ever remember going around there?
Yeah.
So what do you think when you see that?
Probably should have done a better job of cleaning up my phone. It's not something that I want to have easily accessible for others to be able to follow my every step.
Or to reach any friend.
I didn't even know about that app, that all my contacts were still in there. I just assumed that if the bottom one was empty, that they were gone.
Or worse.
The photographs can be used to impersonate that person, could use, you know, or any kind of impersonation.
Are phones considered a prime source for an identity thief?
Oh, absolutely, because you can get access. Most people have all that stuff stored on their phone in some way, shape, or form. If you have a PayPal app, your PayPal information is in there. You know, I know a lot of people will have a document with all of their passwords saved on it. And so if you get
called
access...
passwords?
Yeah, called passwords.
So what should you do? It starts with putting a password on your phone right when you get it. Then, when getting rid of it, remove the SIM card and any other portable memory. Hit factory reset on the handset and make sure it looks like it's taking a long time. That's a good thing. Then, just in case, change the passwords on any apps you've used through your phone. When it comes time to move on or move up, really think about what it's worth to sell the old one versus just hanging on to it.
You trade it in and you're gonna save $50 to $100, but think about the potential loss you have if your data goes out.
But as authorities and tech experts warn, there's still a risk if you're hanging on to the phone.
You know, you get a new phone and you'll just put the phone away in your drawer at home. And if a burglar comes in and breaks into your house and finds a drawer full of phones, that could be the most valuable thing that they steal, is that old cell phone sitting in your old drawer.
So what should you do with it?
You should just smash it. That's the best way.
All that there is left to do is, you know, destroy the phone.
Gina Mangieri, KHON2 News.